I have been adamant in saying that Social Security should not be privatized, and it will not be privatized as long as I'm president. Social Security is not in crisis. What is happening is that the population's getting older, which means we've got more retirees per worker than we used to. We're going to have to make some modest adjustments in order to strengthen it.
All right, so President Obama thinks Social Security apparently just needs a few little tweaks. But with the program set out to pay more than it takes in this year, is he underestimating the problem? And might personal accounts be the best solution? Well, let's talk to former GE and AOL executive Mark Walsh. He's now co-host of Left Jab on Sirius Radio. And Dan Mitchell, senior fellow at the Cato Institute. Dan Mitchell, I know you favor personal accounts. It's not exactly privatization, or maybe it is. But how would that solve the imbalance between benefits scheduled to go out and underreported revenues to come in?
The president is flat wrong. There is a crisis. If you look at the Social Security Administration's long-run forecast and you adjust it for inflation, future deficits total $28 trillion. And that means three things. One of three things has to happen. Either huge tax increases, which would be permanent economy killers, steep benefit cuts, or do what 30 countries around the world have done, countries like Sweden, Australia, Chile, and others, and transition to a system of personal accounts with a safety net, do it over several decades. Yes, there'll be a transition cost, but that transition cost will be a lot less than that giant $28 trillion deficit for a system that fundamentally can't work because of the demographics.
Mark Walsh, are you convinced what Dan Mitchell just said?
No, I'm actually unconvinced. First of all, where do you get $28 trillion? I've never seen that number. And secondly, we have over 35 years to fix this problem. The first year that they expect benefits to be paid out less than what is expected is 2041. So we have a lot of time to fix this problem, number one. Number two, what the president is talking about are long-term fixes. That's increasing the cap on wealthy individuals in pay-in. That's decreasing the payout to wealthy individuals over the life. And it's increasing the retirement age. And number three, if you guys think transferring to private accounts is not going to cost a lot of money and fees and marketing, you're smoking something, and I have a bridge in Brooklyn to sell you. And the final point I'll make is this is not a guaranteed return event. There's no safety net. If I had my special privatized account in Lehman and Bear, where would I be today?
Lehman and Bear, Dan Mitchell. But Dan, your point about Sweden, you said Sweden has moved to private accounts, did you not? Sweden is, kind of a socialist country. What do they know that Mark Walsh and President Obama don't know?
If you look at Sweden, I think it highlights the difference between what I call the responsible left and the demagogic left. What Sweden did is they looked at the demographics, they saw an aging population, and they not only allowed workers to put some of their payroll tax into personal accounts, they also changed the existing government system to a nominal defined contribution system. So not only are your benefits tied to the amount of taxes you pay, but those benefits are automatically adjusted based on what happens with life expectancy. Now, that's a responsible way to be big government, which is a good description of Sweden. Whereas what Obama and Pelosi and Reid and the others are doing is all the sort of demagoguery about some Republican secret plan. I wish Republicans had a secret plan for personal accounts, because all the countries that have done this, Australia, Chile, Hong Kong, you name it, it's much better in the long run for an economy.
Mark Walsh, would you take a second look at personal accounts, or do you prefer benefit cuts and tax increases?
What I prefer is for Americans to save more. And I think to take a portion of what is mandated and correctly relied upon in a very, very low-level return, but it's very conservative, which is called the Social Security system, which has worked for 75 years and has another 40 before there's any major issue, is something we should take very, very seriously, number one. Number two, to increase personal savings, we have to find ways to make the unsophisticated investor, and that's the great majority of America, to trust Wall Street again. Wall Street is now the purview of sophisticated investors. To say that I should take part in my Social Security payments and put it in the hands of people that have driven this truck into the ditch, I think is an unfair suggestion to people that need security.
What's wrong?
Wall Street is not secure.
All right. Wall Street, you can blame Wall Street. Dan Mitchell, personal freedom enters into this, does it not? Consumer choice enters into this, Dan. In other words, are you saying that everyone would be forced to go in, or would you offer them the option of controlling their own accounts?
If you look at most of the personal retirement account systems around the world, people do have a choice. And you find in countries like Chile, more than 95% of people exercise that choice because they know that it's better to have real assets that you can pass on to your children than to rely on politicians. And a good example is the U.S. system. Mark keeps talking about, oh, 2041, we have a trust fund. The trust fund is filled with IOUs. The politicians already spent the money. You can't write yourself an IOU, break into your child's piggy bank, and spend it on a vacation in Las Vegas. That's what we've done with this Ponzi scheme known as Social Security. Security, well, real security, is based on personal accounts with real assets.
All right. I have to leave it there. I'm sorry. We'll do this again. We've debated this thing a lot. We'll debate it again. You both are great. Mark Walsh, thank you very much. Dan Mitchell, appreciate it. Sweden, we appreciate what you've done.